Hi, this is SensorLab. I will measure and review the repeatability of the motorcoder. The motorcoder is a linear encoder without scale. It uses multiple Hall sensors to sense the permanent magnets of a linear motor instead of a scale. For the basic definition of repeatability and accuracy, you can watch the video link below to help you understand it better. I will explain the equipment configuration for repeatability measurement. I use a linear motor, two Mitsubishi servo drives and a PLC. I mounted the motorcoder, a red PCB using Hall sensors, in front of the coil unit, to face the permanent magnet unit in the linear motor. I additionally attached an optical linear encoder head and scale to the side of the coil unit as a reference sensor for comparison. The optical linear encoder outputs an incremental signal, which is input to the first Mitsubishi servo drive, and the position data sensed by the motorcoder is input to the second Mitsubishi servo drive through serial communication. Two Mitsubishi servo drives are connected to a Mitsubishi PLC. To measure repeatability, I control the linear motor with a second servo drive through a Mitsubishi PLC. I simultaneously receive and save position data from two servo drives using PLC. As shown in the graph, I moved and stopped the linear motor 7 times by 150 mm from the origin, then moved it in the reverse direction again with the same motion. I repeated this round-trip operation a total of 10 sets to save the position data of the optical linear encoder and the motorcoder, and compare the position data of the two sensors when the linear motor completely stopped. According to the measurement results, the bidirectional repeatability of the motorcoder compared to an optical encoder is 11 micrometers, that is, plus or minus 6 micrometers. Please refer to the first video below for comparative results on repeatability and position accuracy. The difference between the position data measured with an optical linear encoder and the position data measured with the motorcoder is shown in the following graph. I define the difference in position between the optical encoder and the motorcoder as the error of the motorcoder, because the optical encoder is more accurate than the motorcoder. The maximum error of the motorcoder is about 500 micrometers, and since the permanent magnets of a linear motor cannot be attached at completely equal intervals, the difference inevitably occurs. In other words, since the motorcoder uses a permanent magnet array arranged in a row and a linear motor as a scale, position accuracy error occurs due to permanent magnet attachment error. However, you can see that the repeatability of the motorcoder, that is, the repetitive deviation of the error of the motorcoder, is plus or minus 6 micrometers, which is relatively very precise compared to the position accuracy. If you zoom in on the graph at 150 and 300 millimeters, it looks like the following graph. When repeated 10 times in both directions, you can see that the deviation in the error of the motorcoder is up to 11 micrometers. I will show you the graphs for forward and reverse repeatability of the motorcoder in turn. You can see that the two graphs are similar in that the error of the motorcoder does not increase even if the direction changes. From this, we can see that the main cause of repeatability is the interpolation error caused by the large pole pair pitch of magnet. The motorcoder's accuracy is over 500 micrometers, but its repeatability is about plus or minus 6 micrometers. It's not accurate, but it's precise. Linear motors are not only applied to high-precision applications but also widely applied to long-distance transport up to tens of meters into sites where should not be dust and noise generated due to friction. Until now, linear encoders must be used to drive linear motors. From now on, the motorcoder, a linear sensor using Hall sensors, is a good alternative solution for applications that don't require high accuracy as rechargeable battery manufacturing and smart logistics. We plan to upload data from various linear sensors. If you turn on notifications, it will be more convenient when you watch the next video. Thank you for watching. The Sensor Lab.